make a mistake. Cool. So, Keenan, first of all, I want you to, you know, you're one of the top guys in the company. You just hit the top 20. You're constantly building a team, recruiting people, training people. You're out there knocking on doors. You're out there closing sales. You're out there doing mentor deals. You're doing every aspect of the business, bro. And so I want you to, first of all, give us a little bit about your story. You shared with me a little bit in Vegas about your story and how in the beginning it was a little bit of a struggle. And I think a lot of people can relate to that, right? So what I would like people to do is to get to know who you are and a little bit about your story, and then we'll get into some of the tips and advice that you give people.
Awesome, JC. Yeah. I think first and foremost, I give it back to the leader. I always do this because without you, JC, I wouldn't be here. And everyone on this phone call, we would not be here for the person that said yes to this business. Mm-hmm. The yes factor is so much more than just us sitting in this seat right now. So I said yes to this business. And then from there, 20, 40, 50, and it's going to turn into thousands. So I say thank you for saying yes to the business, because this entire organization is built based on yeses. And so for the people that don't know me, my name's Keenan Garcia. You probably do know me because I promote myself. I show my face. And what I want to get to you guys is that it's not all peaches and cream. It's not like I'm this successful right at the very beginning of this business or in any business. I went through a very tough time, and it was actually because I'm so competitive, it was difficult because I started Powur right at about a year ago. Okay, so it's not been that long, and I've been knocking doors. I've been selling actually everything, alarms, pest control, satellite. I know how to sell. Jumped into Powur, and I'm like, okay, I'm going to crush this. Went out and knocked every day from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m., and there was no deals, JC, no deals. And the people that are on this line, I really want you guys to really soak this in, because it is your own pace, where there's people doing 3-4 deals a week on their very first week. But it took me 4 weeks, literally day in, day out, and zero deals from knocking from 9 a.m. To 9 p.m. every single day. And then at some point I said, okay, all of the hard work is going to pay off. Finally got my first deal in the books, which I knew I was going to get at some point. So I have a lot of life lessons that I'm going to kind of go over today, is long-term vision. I know exactly where I'm going, so nothing like 4 weeks isn't going to stop me. So yeah, everyone goes through these trials and stipulations at the very beginning of their endeavor, but it took me 4 weeks just to get my first deal. And then it actually took me 2 or 3 weeks to get my second deal. But I knew what I was going for, and then that's exactly getting promoted as a top 20 closer, mentor, developer in this company is just the beginning of accomplishment that I had written down. I write everything down. And I wrote that on day one. I said, I'm chasing the top people in this company. I'm going to be recognized sometime. It took me a year to do it. So I'm here in Dallas, Texas, guys. My background is sales. I knocked doors for 8 years, and that's been the best thing that's ever happened to me, is learn how to overcome fear of failure, objections, how to really go through communication skills. Because at that point, all you need to learn in this business is those four simple steps: communication, sales, overcoming objections, and fear of failure. That's what most people don't know how to do in their life, is to get over those little small steps. But there's people like myself, JC, Eric Garcia, Joel, that are here to help you get through those stages. So I'm 29 years old, actually 28. I'll be 29 next Wednesday. So I'm kind of always leveraging that. I'll be 29 next week. And I'm just getting my foot started, JC. I want you to know that when it comes down to joining a business like this, I've been in traditional solar, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been there. I know both sides of the okay, base, your baseline, red line, not getting paid. I know exactly how that is. And I'm so driven right now to get this business out there, because Powur pays. Powur pays. I'm telling you, I've not one time been not paid for my jobs, because when we work, we want to be compensated on our work. We don't work for free. So I want you to know, JC, that this is just the beginning of my endeavor, and I can't wait to see what the future holds. That's a little small little background about me, and I'm an open book, JC. This is an honor, like I said, and a privilege to be here, because I know there's a lot of people been requesting this meeting right here.
That's right. Well, you know what? Thank you for sharing that with us. And, you know, that goes to show you are somebody who already had a lot of experience knocking on doors and in sales. It took you a month, right? Now, I'm not saying that it's going to take everybody here a month. There's some of you guys here that don't have the experience that Keenan had. You started going out there knocking on doors, and it didn't take you a month. It took me over a month to get my first sale as well, and I was hitting the field as well. And I have sales experience, but one of the things, Keenan, that I see about people like you, like myself, that have, and a lot of people on here that have sales experience, is that we know how to warrior it up. And we also know that, hey, listen, it's just a matter of time. So guess what? Maybe it's 1,000 no's that we have to come across before we get that yes, right? So let me ask you this. What advice would you give to a new guy or girl who's just getting started here? Well, if you had to say, hey, here's the next 3 or 4 steps that I would recommend that you do to get your business off the ground?
That's a good question, JC. And I come prepared, because if you're not prepared, you're behind. You're 2 steps behind. So that's one thing that I go over, is knowing that where to start. Very important, because in this business, we're CEOs. We're not consultants. We're CEOs. So being launched into your business is the most important thing. This is not a recruit. This is a recruit and show results. Recruit, show results. And so what I do, just me sharing what I do with my team, is getting started is show me your friends and I'll show you your future. You need to be hanging around the top people in the company. If it's not on like personal level, you need to be around their YouTube channels. I'm on JC's YouTube channel every day. I watch these videos every single day. I watch Charles Thompson, Aguardo, Jonathan Budd every single day. And then I surround myself with the people that are very successful, because as we know, that's a very common term that JC, that you and I have both talked about, is show me your friends and I'll show you your future. And whenever I say friends, business partners, because I don't have drinking buddies. I have business partners where we go out to socialize and we talk business. Okay. Right. The people that I hang myself around, you look at their bank accounts, I think you can agree with this. If you hang around 5 people, you're going to be within that small little budget about where their income level's at. So whenever I joined the business, I was in prior real estate. I still do that right now. I buy and flip homes. I knock on doors asking if I can help them, because I'm a servant leader, to get out of pre-foreclosure. So I was surrounding myself with people that were making $500,000 a year. And I broke that my first year. I didn't make that, but I made $500,000 for that commission for that company. So I said this, I said, I need to hang around the top dog of the company in Powur, because if they're doing it, so can I. So my one, and I'm going to go over 2 things real quick. JC, my first and foremost, for the people that are brand new in this, take a deep breath. I want you to know, and then just stay consistent, but hang around the people that are always going to push you. If you're not calling the leader 2-3 times a day, then you're doing something wrong, because the leaders want to work. I want to work. So that's where I really differ from people that are very successful at the very beginning versus not that successful, because they don't surround themselves with the leaders, your top 5. So write down the top 5 goals. I have to give you guys goals. Write this down for everyone, actually. Who's your top 5 people in this business? That's what I'm talking about. In this business that you want to hang yourself around. Okay, write that down. And then from there, I want you to reach out to them and say, hey, I've chose you as one of my top 5. And I want to learn from you. And then from there, they're going to say, perfect. I've been waiting for that text message, because that's what leaders do. Leaders are always there to uplift, as in a young entrepreneur, because we started exactly where you guys did. And then the reason why we got to where we're at, JC, I think you can agree with this, is because we did that exact step right there. We reached out to people and we asked them questions. Not that difficult. Now, the second thing that I want to go over is, whenever you launch into a business, I call it trench work, JC. And anyone on this call that's on my squad, they know trench work, because I text them every day at 5:50. I wake up at 5:50. Colby can attest to this, many people. And I text them, brand new in the business, trench work, time to work. Because at that point, it's all about getting started. And then you have to go through the trenches in a business so you can tell them how, when it comes down to understanding, whenever they do recruit and saying, I know, because I've been there. I've been in this trench work stage. And I do a 30-day blitz, JC. I do a 30-day balls-to-the-wall blitz. That's going to really show me who's in this business to just get over that little life crisis that they think that they have. But when the person comes into their life, like me, I'm going to push them because it takes one person. That's all it does. So I do a 30-day blitz. I'm accountable for that because I'm always on 30-day blitzes. That's actually nice for me because I get 30-day blitzes every month, every day, because I'm just recruiting. I just recruited one of the top barbers here in Dallas, Texas. You know what? We texted him this morning. I said, ready to work? Time to grind trench work. I just recruited another guy that was in solar. I'm not going to say a name, but he signed day one, signed his contract on day one. $6,000 commission, not about money, but about how simple this business is. We go and we take action. So write this down for the second thing. First one is going to be surround yourself, pick your top five people. And then your second task on just getting launched is a 30-day money blitz, I call it. Because what that money blitz is going to do, JC, is tell a story. Because I don't say, don't recruit a single person joining this business whenever you come in. Because you don't have the proof. This is where network marketing taught me how to be a stone cold killer. Because you have proof, okay, and trust. And if you have proof and trust, it's game over. But at the very beginning, they don't have the new consultants don't have the proof. So what you need to do is create that proof. No matter what it is, if it's one deal, two deals, or 10, like I see and expect, because it's not that difficult if you just stay plugged into the system, is then from there on day 31, do you know what they're going to do whenever they have that now proof?
Sorry, guys. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, now we can.
So that's something I look at, JC, is okay, being in a business like this, it's not about recruiting because that's not where the money's at. It's about personal selling, knowing the business model before you recruit. Okay, so that's task number two. Okay. And, you know, see what that does for you guys because it's working. And I say if it works, then do it.
Nice, nice. Keenan, in sales, right, whether it's solar, real estate, whatever the case may be, it's a different mindset, right? Because we don't have a guaranteed income. And so what kind of advice would you give to the people as far as the importance of having the right mindset? Because you're going to get rejection. You're going to get people that slam the doors on you. You're going to get cancellations. How strong?
Hey, Jason, hold on one sec, my man. I'm so sorry. Someone called me and messed up my mic. I'm going to just admit back in, okay?
Yeah, go for it. Go for it. So on that topic, guys, I want to say, while Keenan gets back, you guys hear me say this all the time. It sounds so simple, but it works. And the people that listen to this, they understand. Here's the deal. Get good at getting three things. Getting the interest of the homeowner, getting the bill, and getting the appointment. I just got a young lady started. Her name is Allie. She got started on Friday. I shared this on the groups, right? She gets started on Friday. She went door knocking on Saturday. She got her first bill Saturday, and we already have an appointment for Tuesday. Why is that? Tuesday, Glendale, in-person appointment. Why is that? The reason why that is, guys, is because I said, get the interest, get the bill, and get the appointment. That's what she did. We already got the first appointment there. But she got started one day, went knocking the very next day. Guess what? No flyers. She didn't have flyers. She didn't have Powur business cards. She didn't even have a polo shirt. So I'm actually going right now through looking at the faces of the people with the cameras on. You know why? Because most people, you hear me say this a million times, and you're going to hear me say it another 10 million. Here's what they do. Aim, 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 aim. They're getting ready to get ready. They're getting ready to go and do some stuff. It's like, dude, I'd much rather you go out there and fire and fall on your face, get a bunch of rejection, but at least you did some shit. And most people, they're just not willing to do this stuff. No flyers, no business cards, no polo shirt. And she got her first bill and her first appointment. Right. So anyways, with that being said, Keenan, I see that you're back, bro.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Sorry about that, bud.
So talk to me about the importance of developing a strong, I call it a bulletproof mindset. As a matter of fact, I have a course, interactive video course on the bulletproof mindset. That's, to me, that's the most important thing, right? And tell me if you agree with me. And here's the reason why I say that. Because all the skills in the world are irrelevant if you don't, if you have a weak mindset that's going to quit every so often, right? So tell me about the importance of a strong mindset, because I know you have a very strong mindset.
Yeah, JC, man, you and I say this from day one, we're cut from the same cloth. And that's just so crazy because that actually was the first bulletin on my notes that I'm going to be doing today. And it's so crazy. It's the exact same concept, but this is my term. Okay. Bulletproof mindset is what gets through you. And I love it, but this is my concept.
Poppy, what a millionaire.
Okay. I'm going to say that one more time. If you want to be a millionaire, you copy what a millionaire does. They have bulletproof mindsets. Okay, bulletin number one that I say here is pretty crazy. Not one millionaire that I know sleeps in. They don't. They don't sleep in. They don't sleep in. I said that's a step number one. If you guys just want to be just an inch and a quarter of where they're at, they don't sleep in. Okay, so the day that I just set my alarm, we're all tired. I say this every day. We're all tired when we wake up. I'm not a morning person. But I have to be a morning person because I want to be a millionaire. That's what millionaires do. So that's bulletin number one. Okay, write that down, guys. I'll send you these notes too, but I expect you guys, if you guys take this, then write it down because this is important. Okay. Millionaires, they don't, thank you, JC. Millionaires don't not exercise, if that makes sense. They exercise every day because it's all about getting your mind right every single day. Okay, so step number one is get up early. Get up early. Okay, don't sleep in. Very simple task too. Exercise. Step number two, exercise. If you're not exercising, I'm so sorry, but that's just taking a step back. It's so easy. And it doesn't matter about going to the gym, but get out, walk, do some crunches, push-ups, because it's all about getting your mind on track and you're winning every single time you do that. Okay, so I do that every day. I wake up early and I go to the gym. And I can go look at my social media. That's proof right there. I do it every day. I swipe, and I'm going to give you guys a task because it's very tough for me to get up, is right when your alarm gets on and turns on, I want you guys to just swipe up on your Instagram, take a photo, and then swipe up, and then push the time, okay? Push what time you woke up, and then I write a quote every day because if I do that without looking at my phone of what maybe potential cancels I have, is that if I write down a good motivational quote every single morning before that gets going, man, you can't stop me. You can't. So typically what I say is most or some will, most won't. Some will, most won't. Every day, look at my, and then I usually say time to grind. Okay, or building an empire day by day. And I'm going to tell you that right there, small little golden ticket is going to change your entire lives, ladies and gentlemen. Just try it, please, because I do it. I say, why wouldn't I just share it? Okay. And then the next bulletin that I wrote down is you have to be doing your daily affirmations every single day. I say not one millionaire doesn't read. If you don't read audio, they don't YouTube mentor, like look at, watch other people in your industry, learn from there. It's free. YouTube University. You know, I say this, college was a waste of my time, waste of my money. Because at that point, I partied my ass off. I went and played baseball, and I'm now $40,000 in debt when I can go on YouTube right now and learn exactly what I went to school for. Okay. And I'm not even using my degree. So whenever it comes down to books, everyone knows that I have books on me on hand. And Big Money Energy is my number one book in my life. It changed my entire life. And I want you guys to read this and drop, if you guys have, drop a little emoji, BME. Right in the group chat, because that right there, I know it's changed your life on just being able to learn from people that are doing what they're doing. It's crazy. How to rule at work, dominate at life, and make millions. Why wouldn't I read that book? And make millions. Dominate it. Okay, rule at work. Yes, I want to do that. Dominate at life. Yes, I want to do that. And make millions. So that's book number one. Okay, book number two is start from zero. That's what we're doing right now. Start from zero. Here, you guys can take a screenshot if you guys want. Okay. It is so build your own business experience of true freedom. Zero ideas, zero cash, zero experience, zero confidence includes 15 real world examples. So why wouldn't you read that too? That's a golden ticket, literally. And then this right here, changed my entire life, is fuck your excuses. And I'm sorry for my language, guys. I'm so sorry. But that's what the book is. And I'm going to say, once you read it, you'll understand why I'm so passionate about this. And one of my guys on here knows exactly what he means because he got that tattooed on his wrist. Is it, when you look at people that say excuses, that's just the way that they've always lived their life. And whenever you get past that mentality, JC, man, I'm telling you, it goes so far. I had a barber, that barber I recruited, one of the top guys here in Dallas, it was late at night, 8 o'clock. I did not want to go to his barbershop an hour away. But I said, you know what? That's an excuse. That's an excuse. I went there, signed him on the spot, and he has five people already that's going to be signing contracts, and he wants to build his business into a multi-million dollar business. Okay, so if I made that excuse and say, you know, it's already too late, I don't want to do this, I didn't get home until 10:30, and Eric Garcia knows this because I went and had some dinner with him at a restaurant here in Dallas, Texas. I'm telling you, I don't stop, guys. And that's one thing you got to learn with that bulletproof mentality. If you look at people that are very successful, they are doing the same traits, maybe different terms. Like mine is, if you want to be a millionaire, you copy what a millionaire does. Okay, but bulletproof mindset, that's exactly what JC is talking about. Okay, JC? And I'll write these books down for you guys, because that right there is, I wish I could make some money on the affiliate referral ambassador, because I'm referring something I stand behind. And that's what something that Powur is so blessed that we have, is that we have the hands down the most amazing ambassador program for being able to refer something that people stand behind. It's never been done before, because I should be rich by now for making this book famous. So that's, I'm just saying right now, man.
I love it, man. I love it. You know what? It's funny. One of the things about a bulletproof mindset that I get into is this, guys. And tell me if you agree. Here's one of the things that you will see, because you see it all the time. Never fails. Somebody gets started in the business. They start making a little bit of money. They start having a little bit of success. Then all of a sudden, they start having excuses. You know why? Because they don't have that bulletproof mindset. Most people don't even get there. However, but sometimes when people get there and they start having some results, they stop being coachable. They stop warrioring it up, right? And one of the things that I like about you is that you're having the results. Getting to the top 20 is not enough. Here's the thing, man. If you decided, hey, I'm making enough passive income and I'm gone, hey, that's cool. But here's the thing, man. Very often I ask people, hey, man, I want you to come on here and I want to interview you. Or you know what? I want you to do the training. And there's always a freaking million excuses. And it's like, hey, man, when I keep getting, now here's the thing. Sometimes there's some valid ones, but sometimes people, you know, same thing with going out there and door knocking. If you get used to making excuses, that's going to be your identity. You're going to have the identity of somebody that doesn't warrior up, somebody that just continues to make excuses and stuff, right? And so talk to me a little bit about your elevator pitch or your pitch at the door. So let's get into the meat and potatoes. Let's get into the how-tos. What is the number one way that you get customers, bro? Talk to me about your pitch to get customers.
Yeah, JC, and this is going to be tailored based on a lot of things, but I'm going to tell you what I do is, and I wrote this down too, is branding. Okay, and this is probably the best way I've ever got customers, and the most strategic way is by putting on your daily shirts, literally on every single day, you're branding yourself into Powur Solar, independent contractor. Okay, make sure you're standing behind compliance as well, knowing that I walk into a gas station right after closing a deal that I got from branding, and then I close another deal from branding. Because here in Texas, as we all know, we're having a big, big now push for renewable because of what happened 11 weeks ago with the whiteout and then the blackout with everything shutting down. And then now here in Texas, they're releasing articles that are expecting another blackout. So I can't believe that when people are walking by, you don't know what business they're in. So, but everyone knows I'm in solar. Literally every single person that I run into is I'm asking them or I'm passing out a business card. Okay, so that's right. First is branding yourself at the gym. People know me for this, is that I go to the gym wearing Powur. I have a hat that says Powur, a tank that says Powur, zip-up hoodies, and that right there is a recruiting tool. I've recruited so many people by just being in the gym, because I give them a compliment. That's another training. I ask them what they do. I say, would you possibly be, by chance, looking to have another stream of income, because you only have one, right? As they say, they only have one income. I say, okay, I got something for you, because if you want to follow someone that's already been in one stream of income, you got to have two streams, three, four, five, six. So the second one is that I always have business cards and I pass them out daily. Literally, I pass these out every single day. And I have this stack right here because I put them in my pocket and I have a goal of passing out 20 business cards a day. So anyone that knows me, I'm always recruiting. I love that. either a customer or a business partner, because I'm not trying to take advantage of them, but I'm trying to get the word out there. And I'm going to put this guy, I'm going to put this an example that Eric Garcia told me. And this is something that, man, it breaks my heart because I see it every day, is that I say, if you don't get the word out there, your next door neighbor will never know. Okay, mm-hmm. I'm going to say that one more time. If you don't get the word out there, your next door neighbor will never know. And that's just in life in general. But I'm going to put it in perspective of, okay, my house here in Grapevine, Texas, and then I walk out of my house, and then next door, my direct next door neighbor is getting installed with solar. And I say, okay, my heart sunk to the very bottom of my stomach. But I'm going to say this is because I never talked to them. And I never talked to them. But they're getting solar right next door to me. Don't do that, guys, because the guy that – does that make sense, JC?
Yes. Same thing happened to me, bro. Same thing happened to me about a month ago. Three houses down, I'm having my morning coffee. They're getting installed. Now, I'm talking to a lot of people every single day, but I didn't – and I called everybody that I know. But one thing I didn't do is I didn't go knock on the neighbor's door, introduce myself, give them my business card or a flyer. And so, yes, absolutely. And guess what? That's what I get. I deserve for that crap to happen to me.
Yeah, and I'm just saying everyone in my neighborhood right now, JC, is getting brand new roofs. And I'm going to go knock on their doors and introduce myself. Hey, I'm your neighbor. Okay, I want to help you. I know what you know that with ERCOT, they're raising their rates, first of all, and they're telling people that you can only use a certain amount of electricity. I'm going to be your neighbor and your go-to person. I'll take good care of you. Okay, so my elevator pitch, JC, is very simple. You have to keep it simple. If people ask what I do, I say solar. That's it, because you don't need to say, oh, I'm a custom energy savings report specialist and I actually diagnose kilowatts. No, just say, I own a solar company here local. I'm a local business, and by chance you have someone outside that I can help, we're in 26 states that I can provide service in. And then you got to know the background of the company. Okay, so that's something that I stand very passionate about, is that I know the pitch based on every single Monday tonight, 7 Central Standard Time, they go over the business model. And I know everything about this business from day one. Actually, I knew this because I care about what I'm saying to other people as a professional. Okay, so my elevator pitch is very confident. You can write this down, is that people will read your confidence no matter what you're saying. As long as it sounds like you know what you're talking about, you're going to be able to get that trust past it, and then from there, deliver, okay? And you always have to ask an open-ended question based on either a yes or a no, and for example, I would say this, is that I own a solar company. Have you ever considered weighing your options? Because most people, they don't get to that step. They either say yes or no. Say, okay, if they say yes, I say, perfect. You must know a lot about solar, and was there a reason why you didn't move forward? Was it, I'm sure, the price? Or blah, blah, blah. And they're going to tell you, say, perfect. That's actually completely different. The reason why I'm here is because I can actually represent you. I work on the behalf of you so you can make a yes. Boom. And then if they say no, say, oh, wow. Okay. That's where I'm stepping in as a professional. And my obligation, because I'm obligated, is to get you a free estimate. Now, all I need is your electricity bill. And then I have this scan code, guys, on here. That scan code goes right to my back office. So you have to streamline this thing, because when it's so difficult to get an estimate, then they're not going to give you their information. So I say this, I need you to scan this code for me. I do it right on the spot. This is what most people don't do. They're going to make business cards, obviously, with a QR code, but they don't walk them through the steps. So if I ever run across someone that wants a free estimate, JC, I have them scan my code, and then I take their phone from them, literally, and I say, I'm going to just do this for you. What's your first name? What's your last name? What's your area code? What's your average bill? And then I'm going to push submit automatically, just like that. It goes straight to your back office. And then from there, I have everything that ultimately will be able to be me in control. Because if you give them your business card, you're going to be chasing them down. You don't know if they scanned it. You don't know if they put in their information. That's a lost customer. But what a professional does is they walk people through it, because they're all going to say yes.
I love it.
One of the things that caught my attention about what you said earlier was this. You said that you were knocking or prospecting, working from 9 to 9. Tell me about that.
My lady's on the line. She'll tell you this, that it was very tough. It was a very difficult time in my life because, and I'm going to tell you, it wasn't all peaches and cream, guys. I was, you know, I drive a nice car and, you know, but at that time of my life, I was transitioning from one business to another and it was very tough. And at some point, I didn't even know if I was going to have gas to get down to that spot, which was 45 minutes from there. And, you know, don't ever judge a book by its cover and don't ever judge someone driving a Lamborghini or Range Rover because you never know who's coming after them to repo their car. And my car was getting repoed at that time, JC. And I'm going to be very vulnerable at this time because people need to hear this. That whenever you look at someone and you say, ah, man, I wish I could just be in their shoes. You never know what they're going through. And so at that time in my life, JC, I knew that I had to do it. I knew that I had to go out there and pound doors when I didn't want to. And that was the best thing that's ever happened to me because at that point, going through a life struggle and overcoming those life struggles fucking built me to be the man that I am. No one can tear me down. There's not one person, not one homeowner that can say no to me because whenever you have that deep down inside, that feeling knowing that whenever you help someone saying, Keenan, thank you for either the business side of things, you changed my life, got me out of rehab, caught him at a car wash, completely taking his life away, changed it 100%. Or that customer that said, Ken, I was struggling to pay my bills. My lights were about to turn off. You knocked on my door 9 o'clock at night, and I can't thank you enough for that one time, guys, is that you're never knowing, you never know whose life you're going to impact. That's what I live. I live my life based on that. I'm obligated for the rest of my life, JC. And the times that I was doing that built me to the person I am today. And everyone knows that. Be vulnerable, guys. And ladies and gentlemen, be vulnerable. Tell people your stories. Tell people that you haven't had this type of success or support. Because if you go to any other company and tell them that story, they say, go boohoo, go knock doors for me. But here, Power, no, we're family. We here are going to support you through those tough times. And you know what? There's one guy, I said, hop on in. Hop in my car, we're going knocking because he's going through the same struggle. And I'm here to support you, brother, because if by chance we're going to do this, which we are, you're going to go right through those stages with me.
I love it, man. I love it. One of the things that you did is that you burned your ships. When you got started with Powur, you literally went out there. Well, not literally, but you went out there and burned your ships. You said, hey, this is what I'm going to do, and I'm going to go all out, right? That's what I did as well. When I got started with Powur, I didn't think of Powur like, oh, this is my side business. This is a business. I thought of Powur like, this is my business that I own. And this is my career path. And this is what I'm going to do for the next 10 to 20 years. As a matter of fact, all of you guys know, I always tell people, part of the steps is interest bill appointment. But another thing is make a list of minimum 100 people, call them and to let them know that you're in the solar industry. Here's the thing though. 100 people will hear that, 2 people will do it. Literally sit down, make a list of 100, 150, 200 people. Go through your phone or your contacts. Go through your Facebook. Go through your Instagram. Write them down. Call them. And here's the way it is. Here's what I said to people. I was so committed, man. I said, hey, Keenan, small talk, blah, blah, blah. After the small talk, listen, bro, the reason why I'm calling you is because I just got started in the solar industry. Okay. I am a solar consultant. This is what I'm going to be doing for the next 10 to 15 years. I'm very excited about it. And the reason why I'm letting you know is that in case you know of anybody that either has questions about solar or anybody that may be interested in solar, I would appreciate if you'd keep me in mind. That's it. You're not selling. But guess what that did? That got me recruits. That got me leads. That got me deals, right? Not a whole ton, but what it did do is it got me a bunch of business in the future because I planted the seeds early on. So I would make those phone calls during the day and recruit during the day, and then I would go prospect in the night. So that's one of the things that I saw that you did. You burned your shifts. You said, hey, listen, this is what I'm going to do. And you went and you worked 12 hours a day, it seems.
Yeah, I still do that, JC. I still work 12 hours a day, my friend. And that's where it really makes the difference. On a bulletin that I wrote here, and it's all about consistency. Okay, I wrote it right here. I'm gonna send you guys these notes. I have it right here. I still do that. You know, I'm working, yeah, not for only myself, but I'm working for my team. Because if you're not in the trenches with your team as a leader, then what are they going to do whenever they become a leader, quote unquote? They're going to be just sitting back and chilling at the house. No, that's not what I do. You know, no. I'm actually always phase one. And you know this, JC, always being phase one. I'm in trench work every single day. I'm going right after this to close a deal. I'm going after that, 3 o'clock, close a deal with the new consultant, LB. He's on the line from Jonathan Bernasso. Because what Jonathan Bernasso saw was that I was promoting myself as a leader. So that's what leaders do. They're always in phase one. They're recruiting, they're duplicating, they're training, and then they're on their own so they can do the same thing. So, yeah, I was doing 12-hour days, very, very difficult 12-hour days, man. I had to go to the store and get the Lunchables, the pizza Lunchables, bro. And I had to get the dollar waters because I didn't have money, man. I'm going to be very honest with you, brother. I was making great money with real estate. Pandemic hit. Zip. But now I know what I've been through, and I've told myself and I've told my lady that I'll never be there again. And I know it. I'll never be there. Whenever I had that phone call that where the guy was going to come repo my car, I said, please don't. I just need one more week. And you know what happened on that? Because the good man upstairs blessed me with my first M1 paycheck, $2,000. Okay.
Nice.
1,000, 50-50 split. Paid my car. Man, I'm feeling good. Back in the work. Back in the trenches. My bank accounts, just so you know, they show little to none, not zero. I don't see my money. My lady handles my money. So what I look at every day is 0,000. And I'm like, shit, I got to go. I don't even see, just a rule of thumb, guys, whenever you get to this, I don't see my M2 paychecks. Boom, goes into a whole separate account. I work for M1, okay? We work for M1s because that keeps me hungry. And you know, another thing, JC, I'm going to keep rolling because this right here is, if you're not tracking your goals, that's number two, track your goals, okay? You have to know your goals. Because I was on a Zoom call with Jim Bunch in our breakout session, and I was the only person on that was actually going over the exact goals that I know I'm chasing. I'm chasing $500,000 this year in commissions. I know exactly how many deals that I have to do every single day, every single week, every single month. And then that's not even recruiting or passive.
Oh, Keenan, you there?
You guys there?
Yeah, there you go.
You guys there? Okay. Yeah. I'm going to share a business plan. If you guys haven't got on this, you know, I'm sorry, but this is, you guys should be having this business plan, but it's in the power.live. Okay. I just shared it in the group. It's a business plan PDF. Print that off. That's your step one right there. Is knowing that if you want to be a millionaire, that's what millionaires do. Print it off. Write down your goals. Okay. And track your goals. Because if you're not tracking your goals, you have no drive in your life. If you don't have something you're reaching and chasing, like I'm chasing JC Rangel for that number one spot, I'm coming. You know what I mean? Because I have these goals. And it's nice because you know I'm coming for you. So what that's going to do is push you even harder. I'm coming from DG. I'm coming for Chris. I'm coming for the top leaders of the company. Because that's what we ultimately need in our lives is the people that you're chasing. If it's not the top in the company, go to the person that's very successful and chase that person and go and get it.
That's right, man. That's right. And you know, you touched on this earlier. If you want to achieve big, find out somebody that has what you want, do what they do, and you'll get what they got. It's very simple, right? It's okay to be a copycat as long as you copy the right cat. Something that I say all the time, right? And so to me, when I came on board, nobody, you know, everybody was busy. Jonathan had, for example, my leadership. He has never really done door-to-door sales, right? He started solar with, you know, a different model. Then when he came to Powur, he already had an existing book of business and he got a lot of referrals. I didn't get anybody to teach me the door-to-door script, but I had done door-to-door with ADT. I said, well, shit, I don't care. I'm going to go and I'm going to make one up at the door. And if it's wrong, I'm going to fix it. And eventually it's going to be good. And then I'll teach that to my people. Literally nobody told me what to say at the doors. Literally nobody gave me a flyer. Hey, here's a flyer. Go make one for yourself. I went on canva.com and I created a flyer for myself. And that's a flyer that a lot of the people on my team use. I went and I designed my own business cards, literally designed them myself, ordered them. And then guess what?
I went out there and I started visiting new homeowners. I just knock on the door and I say, how you doing? My name is JC. I'm the solar guy in the area. Just want to drop this off for you, a flyer. Gave it to him. I say, by the way, congratulations on your new home. It's beautiful. They're like, oh, thank you. I say, by the way, have you ever considered solar? That's it. And then they're either going to say yes or they're going to say no. And here's my philosophy. Tell me yes or tell me no, but tell me fast because I got to go. And I had a goal. You talked about goals. I had a goal. How many people, how many doors am I going to visit every single day? And I had a goal. How many days a week am I going to do that? And I wrote those goals down. And guess what? I just freaking went and did them. Because I said, why did I go and do them? Because I said I was going to go freaking do them. That's it. I didn't let, oh, you know what? It's sprinkling a little bit. It's a little bit cold. Or you know what? They invited me to lunch. Forget that. I'm trying hard not to cuss because I like to think of myself as a man that doesn't cuss anymore. I said, forget that. I said, I'm going to do it. And you know what? When I got started, I don't know if you know, but I mentioned on one of the groups, I'm going to go to the top of this company, right? And people didn't believe it. I said, watch, because here's one thing that I know. We, Keenan, you and I, and a lot of people on here, we don't have competition. Nobody's really trying. There's a bunch of people that say, hey, man, this time I'm going to go out there and do it this time. And here's the thing. I promise you when I'm saying this, I'm not saying this. No, there's no individual in my mind that I'm picturing when I say this. I'm saying this in broad, you know, in broad strokes. But I guarantee you that a lot of people listening to the replay or listening to this live are thinking, damn, JC's talking about me. I'm not. But if the shoe fits, then the shoe fits. But I will tell you this much, man. 5 years from now, 1 year from now, 3 years from now, you're going to wish that you took this business seriously. And part of the reason, Keenan, why people do not take the initiative is because of a lack of personal growth. They don't read books. They don't read books. They don't go through audios. They don't invest in themselves, right? Yes. Look, there's people on your, I'm sure there's people on your team, Keenan, that you told attend the Force of Nature event. Yep. $35, $149. I'm sure there's people on your team that said that they wanted it, but guess what? They didn't attend it. Can we agree?
Yeah, that's right, JC. Let me speak on that topic because that's so important. And I'm going to really say this because I wrote this down as well. Everything that he's saying is I address it because that's something that we do as leaders, okay, is that you have to plug into the system. Guys, man, this is the craziest thing of my entire life is that it is just that simple. If I can say just one thing right now, it is just, if you plug into the system, you'll be successful. And then I look at these Zooms, man, and they're like, yeah, I'm going to be successful. I'm going to be on these. They're never on them. They're never on them. Okay. Right. I'm on every single, literally every single. And I know JC is because I look at who's on there and I'm on every single, anything that the company promotes, I'm on there. Monday, 7 o'clock Central Standard Time. I'm on there. You know it. I'm on there. Then from there, Tuesdays, I'm on there with Jonathan Bernasso. I'm on it Monday. Every week, I'm on it. And I say this where it's like, okay, at that point of the game, if you can't even be on something just virtually, I'm not going to take you serious. Because until you do that one thing for me, then I will continue to deliver what I will promise. And you're going to be successful. But if you can't just plug into the system, because the system is built for people just like us, that's step number one, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, I can talk about all my success, but I started from the basics. You got to go back to the basics, and plugging into the system is exactly what leaders do. Okay, JC, that's super important on that one. And I wanted to just go over on how important it is to just plug into a system that's already built.
Yep. Tell me, let's say, for example, I'm brand new and I'm like, bro, I want to get to mentor. I want to make some money. What is the fastest way for me to go get deals on the board? What would you tell me?
I'm going to tell you right now is you have to be doing everything. You have to be knocking doors. Number one, every single day, knocking doors, because that's the best way to do it. I'm telling you right now, if you guys go out there and knock a door and then just put a mentor to the deal, they're going to close it, obviously, because we just are ready for this. And you got to get out there and pound doors because that's what's duplicatable. Okay, you plug into a system, you don't step up, you don't just sit at the house and just wish that they're going to come to you. No, you got to knock doors. But as a business owner, because that's what we are, we have to calendar it. We have to time block. There's a good time to knock doors and there's a bad time. from like 9 a.m. to 12 is not really a good time to knock doors unless you're in middle class, which that's where I go to strategically. Okay. So what I do is I time block. So this is a really good term, JC, for anyone that's starting, is you got to think of it as in a fishing pole. Okay. Is would you rather, I'm going to ask you a question, JC, would you rather have 10 fishing poles in one pond or one fishing pole in 10 different ponds?
I'd rather have one fishing pole in 10 different ponds.
Perfect. Because that right there is getting more avenues to catch that one fish, which is a deal, a closed deal. Okay. So what I do is I recommend this every single day to anyone that's starting, is to go on to Facebook Marketplace every morning and post 10 Facebook Marketplace ads. They're free. Okay. And if you guys need help on that, reach out to me, because there's a very strategic way to do it. And I'm just telling you right now, because I still do this today, JC, is that I got a custom patio, solar patio here on Friday from a free Facebook ad. And it is going to be absolutely killer because it's in a brand new development. And then what they said is that everyone is looking for this, which is solar, because that's the only time they can get a custom built patio by me, is that if they get solar. I say, if you don't want solar, then I'm sorry, you have to go find a new custom builder, because I take my clients very serious. So that's step number one. And that's just one pond. Okay. You got to be reaching out on Facebook to your personal friends, like you just said. Yep. More exposure, more money. Write this down, guys. And ladies, is more exposure, more money. You got to be doing this every single day. I do this every single day. Okay. Step number three is reach out to real estate agents, roofers, and ask for the business. Okay. Ask for the business, not to recruit them, but just ask a roofer, say, hey, I know that you're in the industry, and by chance, do you know any of your clients that I can get a list from? I need you to send me your top 10 clients, and I'm going to call them on the behalf of you, and I'm going to represent you as your energy specialist. They get a complimentary estimate by having a roof replaced by you, and I'm going to take good care of them. Oh, and by the way, you get $1,000 for every single person that I get on solar for just giving me a list. That's it. Okay, so that's pond number three. Pond number four is taprooting. Taprooting is so powerful based on, if you don't know anyone, which is an excuse, that doesn't want solar, ask someone that does want solar. Okay, because it's like, at that point, you got to do whatever. You got to do the small things to get through the just the little beginning of the business. Step number four is when it comes down to like bandit signs, is I put these bandit signs all over a neighborhood, and I get so much exposure, and people that just want solar, they call me. That's the best $2.50 I've ever spent in my life. So I have not only one fishing pole in one pond, I have 10 fishing poles in 10 or one fishing pole in 10 different ponds. And I really hope you guys can get that concept. If you guys don't, then reach out to me, because it's going to be very difficult if you're just doing one, because right, you're going to get torn down to pieces in this nasty world we live in, because it's like some people aren't bent, built to just hear the no's. But just so you guys know, is I went through the no's. I don't even hear no anymore.
That's right.
I hear not educated on solar. I say, when they say no, they say,
I love that.
They say, I don't know what it really means to go solar, or I haven't had the right person come into my life. And I'm going to write down that no, and I'm going to write next to it, and I'm going to say yes. And that's a challenge for me. That's literally a challenge, because I'm obligated to get them the information the right way. The right way.
Okay? And so you know what?
Yes, sir.
Another thing that I see that is a common attribute between people that are successful in anything, in this case, let's talk about you. The reason why you sell is because you are around the bonfire. You are around the information. You believe in the product. Why do you believe in the product? Because you've sold it. But why have you sold it? Because you got trained, because you learned the business, because you're consistent. Because you made a decision is most important. You made a decision that you're going to become a solar professional. You only 1 year in the industry. Me too. You're closing more deals. You and your team are closing more deals than dealers that have been in business for 10 years. Me and my team, we're closing more deals than dealers that have been in business for 10 years. And people are like, how's this solar rookie closing 210 kilowatts in 40 days? Well, let me tell you why. Because I made a decision. Because I am all in, because I have enthusiasm. Listen, look at the word enthusiasm. The last three letters are ISM. I am sold myself. I'm sold myself on solar. I'm not
dipping my toe in the water. Let's be honest, guys. Let's be honest, T. Because I don't sugarcoat stuff. Do not come on my training if you're easily offended and you have, oh, I'm sensitive, like this culture that we live in where everybody's offended by everything. I don't care. Here's one thing I'm going to tell you, man. There's a bunch of toe dippers, people that dip their toe in the water. And let's face it, every team has it. My team has it.
They're going to do that in any industry that they go into, JC. Yes. That is a day that we live in. They think that – I watched a video this morning, Positive Affirmation, and I'll send it to you right after this because exactly what you just said, it's Ryan Serhant sitting in a car, and there's a rock building that is just so dark out this window. Okay, if you look at that, it's just down, and man, it's just depressing. And then on this side is bright sun. It's sunny, it's bright. It's a matter of what angle that you want to look out the window at.
That's and right.
Everyone looks out dark, this like pity, just feel bad for me, and is it never going to go in my direction? No. Look out the damn other window because it's wide open. And then the last thing that I always say, JC, on that concept is that look at this, because this is so true, is look at my hand. Okay, and I'm right here, and I'm going to be reaching down, okay? Anyone in this business right here, all you have to do for everyone in this top leadership position, they're reaching their hands right here down. But we never know whenever you're reaching up if you don't do it. Mm-hmm. We are right there to just take that damn hand and then get you up the elevator way faster than we did because we're going through the ruts to get you faster. But we will never know if you don't just reach up because that's my right. hand's right here. But if you don't ever text me, if you don't ever call me, how are we going to know that you need help? And that's power. Yes. Power is your hand right there reaching down. And I reached up day one. I said, I'm going to admit it. I need help. And that's one thing that people don't do in our lives is that they don't reach out because the pride, their age, they're 38 years old. And I can't ask Keenan, 28-year-old, for help. No, that's what we need to reshift our minds
to. Because there's
people like 7 years old making $22 million on YouTube. I would ask him what he's doing. Because I'm not afraid to ask people what they've accomplished in their life. And this is a life goal of mine, guys. I do this still today. If someone is driving a Lamborghini or maybe something that you guys admire, I always go straight up to them. And I compliment them first because everyone likes a compliment. Step number two is saying, if you don't mind me asking, what do? Because you have something that I want that I don't have yet. You know what they always tell me? They say, you know, they respond back to you very easily. And then I say, if you don't mind, could I just get your personal number? Because I want to learn from you. I want to be where you're at. You know what they do? Yeah, here it is. Here's my number. And then you know what I do is I take action. That's why I met JC. That's why I met JC in Las Vegas. You know what? Because I look up to you, JC. I look up to you. So you know what? I said, no, I'm going right to him. We had one of the best conversations that night. Because of that right there, it's changed my entire mentality. So thank you, my friend.
Thank you, man. Well, listen, the feeling is mutual, bro. I look up to you. I see you working. I see you hustling. And you're 28 and I'm 38, right? And I feel like I'm 28, right? I work out, you know, 4 or 5 days a week. Not as much as you, man. I don't have guns like you. You know what I'm saying? But I strive to have guns like you. But you know what, though? My mindset is I'm going to just warrior up because my mindset is I'm not doing this for me only. I'm doing this for my wife, my mother, my kids. I have a 7-year-old son. I have another on the way. Baby Alexander's on the way. And so my mindset is, hey, man, they didn't ask to come here. We brought them here. So I better give them the best life possible. So you know what? I'm not going to half-ass this business. I'm going to go to sleep tonight. And here's the thing. Here's one thing I'm going to have you write down. Every night, you should ask yourself a couple of questions. Number one, would I do business with me? Ask yourself that question. Would you do business with you as a customer or as a team builder, as a consultant or a customer? Would you do business with yourself? See, look at yourself in the mirror, because when you ask yourself these questions, your heart is going to answer and your mind is going to answer. Your heart will answer the truth. Your mind may lie, but your heart will answer the truth. So would I work with me? Number two, if my team did what I did today, how much money would we make? Think about it. Did you prospect? I closed 3 deals last week. I'm going to close 2 deals today. right? I know you're going for that Tesla, bro, and I'm going for that Tesla too. May the best man win, whether it's one of us or somebody else, may the best man win, right? But do if my team did what I did today, how much money would we make? And the last question is this: do I deserve to sleep tonight based on my labors? You know, the good book says the sleep of a laboring man is sweet. The Bible says the sleep of a laboring man is sweet. You should be too tired at night to worry and too busy during the day to worry. I don't worry. I'm going to just go out there and crush it. And then I'm too busy during the day. Then at night, I go to sleep and I know you do as well, Keenan, I deserve to sleep tonight. So one advice that I would give you guys, because a lot of you guys are part-time, you know this. Work part-time, work full-time on your job and work part-time on your future. Guess what? Power is your fortune and your future. Work full-time on your job and part-time on your fortune. So if you work 8 hours a day, if you're dedicate 8 hours a day to a boss to build his dreams, why wouldn't you dedicate at least half of that time to build your dreams? Make no mistake about it. You got people like Keenan, people like myself, people like other people on here. Mark my words, 5 years from now, there's no way we're going to be worth less than $10 million. No way. These videos are recorded. And there's people that could go right along with them. All ships rise with the tide. So I would encourage you guys, have a sense of urgency. If you are 5 hours away from California, make it to California, Southern California. Make it to Southern California for this weekend's event to learn from myself, Jonathan Brunasso, Charles Thompson. Be at the event. Who do you know? Make phone calls. Get people. Get guests there. Have a sense of urgency. Keenan, any parting words, bro, before we close out this call?
I sure do. And I could go on and on and on, JC. And I really value this time that we've had. But I'm so thankful you asked me about a closing word. Because you brought something up just now, just probably a little bit ago, about your mother, about your wife, about your kid, and about what you're going for. And there's probably not one thing that could ever stop you up until you've done that. And you probably already have, at least I know you've retired your mother. And guys, ladies on this call, guys on this call, you have to have that drive. Okay, because you're going to have your ups, you're going to have your downs. You are going to go through so much throughout this business that you have to open up your phone. Okay, I'm going to show you mine right here. Okay, it's my lady. Okay, on this phone. On the phone that I'm recording on, is that it's my five-year-old little nephew. And when I opened, because I just got the brand new Z Fold 2, which you should get, is I have my whys. I have so much drive inside me, JC, that I can't stop until I know that that little boy, that little five-year-old is taken care of. I say it every single day. And whenever I have people tell me no and bash me and saying, go get a real job and shut the door right on my face, I say, I open up my phone, I say, I got you, buddy. Because you can't tell me no. And my mother is also another, sorry guys, I get so passionate about this. My mother, I'm going to retire her. It's not if, it's when, it's sooner than later, because I am so driven right now to go after what no one can tell me what to do. And no one can stop any of us to go out and just accomplish your goals, but you're going to have that why. And my why is so much and it's so big that I can't wait to get there. And you know what? I'm chasing the best versions of myself, JC. And then the last thing that I can say is that because I'm always learning from other people, if you guys really want to learn from the mentor, his name's Ed Milet. Okay. Ed Milet, we all know him. If not, you have to learn from this man. And he says this, he says, okay, there's us down here and there's a version of us upstairs. Okay. If you believe in, I'm a Christian, is that there's a person upstairs that is the best version of Keenan Garcia. And I'm working every single day, day in, day out, to be that person upstairs. And whenever I meet him, when the good man upstairs takes my time, I'm going to shake my Keenan Garcia up there, and he's going to say, I'm glad you did it. Nice to meet you. I knew that you can go that far. I was watching you down there whenever you had your Range Rover repoed. Or repoing, but I knew you can get through that. I shook, and I'm going to shake his hand. I said, thank you for pushing me, because I knew I could be there. And I challenge you guys to do the same thing. You're not looking at anyone else. You're not comparing to anyone else. But upstairs, there's a person that is the best, most beautiful, spiritual, positive millionaire, because that's what we should be. Okay, it's not about money, but you can do a lot with money. That I'm chasing that, no one can stop me, JC. No one, man. It's been an honor. It's been a blessing. I want to do this more because my mission on life is to impact someone's life. And if I impacted one person's life on this phone call, my hand's right here. My hand's down right now. All I need you to do is just reach up. That's it, guys. God bless you. Stay humble. And I'm so blessed to have you in my life, JC.
Thank you, Keenan. Likewise, bro. I'm blessed to have you in my life, and you definitely impacted people's lives, bro. So I appreciate you. Guys, I hope you guys were paying attention, taking notes, because there was a lot of value dropped on this training here today. I'm going to upload the recording to our YouTube channel. Let's go out there and crush it, guys. I'm excited. Listen, I'll share with you one last challenge on my end. Some of you guys know that a couple of months ago, I got chronic laryngitis. As of right now, I'm still only 50% of the way because it's not fully recovered because I talk a lot. So I'm going to ask for help on these trainings. I asked 3 people for help on the team today. None of them were available. They all had some important things to do, no problem. I appreciate Keenan getting on here, okay? I was close to canceling this, and I said, no, I got to figure it out. We got to do this training because the team needs a training, okay? And unless you've had it, you don't know how bad it is. It's bad. And I still got to conduct business the rest of the day. But I just share that with you to share with you. Everybody has their things that they're dealing with. Okay. Luckily it's a physical thing, right? All my family is healthy, but I appreciate you guys. Catch the recording. Anybody that hasn't, that wasn't on here, I recommend that you send this recorded training. I'll send it on the groups. I recommend that you send this recorded training to your team and make sure that they watch this because there was a lot of information. I appreciate you guys. We'll talk soon. Let's crush it.